Okay, a round of applause for my panelists, not for me.
Thank you so much.
So this panel is about how communication can enable a more sensitive approach towards gender, the way we look at gender, not to normalize things which a lot of communicators do. When I say communicators here, I don't mean the PR people. I'm not talking about PR alone. I mean filmmakers, journalists, everybody who sends out information in the public domain is a communicator here. I'll begin my question with Priti. Priti, do you think communication actually has a huge role to play to sensitize people about creating very socially responsible behavior, especially with issues like women's safety and gender discrimination being spoken about?
Sure. Communications for the longest period of time has been that platform and medium, not only for people to express their voices, but also put their opinions. It's also about a platform where you can challenge the status quo and make sure that anything that has been taken wrong or taking a wrong direction, you have the ability to communicate that in a way saying that no, we as a community say no to this particular reform. Also, when it comes to communication for a country like India and specific topics on gender diversity or gender gap, I was reading this study from UN General which says that it's only gender gap which is contributing to 19% of the cost for the GDP. So if you imagine an economic development that's a reform that country like India is looking at, if we were to really liberate women to a level where they have equal representation, we have the great opportunity. And from communications point of view, mass communications, we all know. There are so many ways we can communicate. It's the movies, it's the radio, it's the digital plethora of so many platforms today, mainstream media. But more than that, each one of us has an expression to express ourselves with all the digital social platforms that we are using today. And I think that's helping us form that opinion for our community.
Arpana, as an RJ, you have you deal with public in a very large way. How important is communication to bring a certain kind of change in the way society perceives women, especially, you know?
Okay. First of all, I'd love to thank everybody for inviting me over here, and hi to all, and best wishes to all of you. वो इसलिए क्योंकि रेडियो जॉकी को बर्दाश्त करना आसान बात नहीं है. अक्सर हम
The mic is in my hands also.
अक्सर हम जानते हैं कि हम लोग रेडियो सुनते हैं और उसके बाद क्या होता है कि आप फ्रीक्वेंसी चेंज कर देते हैं द मोमेंट आपको लगता है बाहर आ गया और ये बकबक करेगा इसके अलावा कुछ नहीं. खैर, कमिंग बैक टू द टॉपिक, कम्युनिकेशन की अगर हम बात करें इस वक्त में तो देयर आर वास्ट थिंग्स थ्रू विच वी कैन कम्युनिकेट बट देयर आर वेरी फ्यू थिंग्स थ्रू विच वी कैन गेट द फीडबैक. रेडियो पर बैठकर, स्टूडियो में बैठकर बहुत से ऐसे लोगों को मैंने अपने आप ही बातें करते हुए सुना है कि हाँ, हम लोग ऑफ होते हैं तो बोला जाता है कि लेट्स टॉक अबाउट मी टू. फाइन, मी टू में क्या हुआ कि बहुत से लोगों ने बहुत सी चीज़ों पे इल्ज़ाम लगाए, लड़कियों ने पार्ट लिया गया वहाँ पे महिलाओं का. बट ऑफ होते ही बात आती है कि नहीं, यहाँ पर मेल जो था वो बिल्कुल ठीक था, गलती फीमेल की थी. तो व्हाई वी वर हियर टू टॉक अबाउट वुमन एम्पावरमेंट, मुझे लगता है ये वक्त है कि अब मेन एम्पावरमेंट के ऊपर बात करनी चाहिए, बॉयज़ के ऊपर बात करनी चाहिए. दिस इज़ द राइट टाइम टू टीच आर बॉयज़ व्हाट इज़ राइट एंड व्हाट इज़ रॉन्ग, प्लस टू टीच आर वुमेंस व्हाट इज़ राइट एंड व्हाट इज़ रॉन्ग. हर चीज़ को लेकर एक मुद्दा उठाना बंद कर देना चाहिए. और जैसा आपने पूछा मुझसे रूहेल रिगार्डिंग कम्युनिकेशन, द थिंग वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम आवर स्कूलिंग एंड बिफोर दैट द बेस्ट थिंग टू कम्युनिकेट is our home. We should teach our child what is good and what is bad. तो इस communication को अगर हम घर से ही शुरू करते हैं तो वो सबसे best part रहेगा. उससे आपको feedback भी मिलेगा, आपका बच्चा क्या response देता है आपको. तो at least we should start in this way.
So talking about me too, you know what has happened when it started, we all felt that this is the beginning of a new movement, but later on we came to know that a lot of fake cases were there.
Exactly.
So my question is, when you are out there communicating about social change, how important is responsibility? Are you responsibly communicating, not maligning anybody without proof? So when you are acting as a communicator for change, how important is responsibility as a factor in that? Any of you?
I think as communicator, it's not only the power for you to communicate yourself and express your opinions. You need to realize that it is the participation from your end and an influence that can create and that can come from just that one single voice. You have that responsibility today to form your opinions which are socially, culturally, aspirationally, morally so strong and so sounded that you have a credibility of being seen yourself. If today we see celebrities and they're really talking about something which is gibberish enough and does not has a relation at all, and it is taking into a very negative direction, that's a negative influence. I think as a responsibility, we need to balance that social context, we need to balance a cultural context in our conversation and make sure that everything is sustainable to a positive direction. And I think that's one responsibility, Ruhail, we need to take up.
Okay, fine, Priti. I just wanted to know, okay, what is the negative impact? I think you are talking about Kabir Singh.
RJ speaking to you.
Right. Yeah, RJ speaking to me. So I would say anything which is harming the society, which is causing a break and a halt to progressive thinking.
Okay, what's your point of view?
Right.
I just wanted to know regarding a movie Kabir Singh.
Regarding the
Kabir Singh.
One second. How many of you think that as a communicator, that filmmaker re-christened the stereotype? I mean, it brought back the stereotype. How many of you agree to that? Okay. Yeah.
So you are in favor of Kabir Singh? Not at all, nah? Then few hands, I must say. Just a few hands. You are in favor?
Who is in favor of Kabir Singh?
I'm not in favor of that movie. I'm so sorry. I didn't like that.
So I think there have been clamor of so many conversations for the movie, by the movie, and as a protagonist, the actor himself chose to be into that role. I don't think he was financially motivated to pick up that role, but he knew what is he driving the conversation for. And in many realities, if I may to say and put some numbers, these are happening, and these are happening in terms of the rage that people are carrying this. Only that he chose the medium and through this movie that this rage exists. I'm against the protagonist, to be very honest. But I think the medium had its own way to express that rage is happening in the society. There have been malpractices happening in the society. There has been lack of understanding that even if it's two couples, they can really relate to the community with a talk message. So movie could be one. There are other movies like Arjun Kapoor playing a role where he's actually half taking care of the domestic help. I think that's another positive change that we can really look at. So there are things which are happening in right ways and the wrong ways. To your question, what is negative impact? Anything that puts a halt to the progression, for me, is a negative impact.
I will ask one more question. Then the trick is I want to open up right after I have 12 minutes left. After that, I want some questions, if anyone has questions. My point is, do you think it's up to the communicator itself to bring in the change? Because what about the social setup, for example? Are you limited by that? You can just put something out in the open, but how that is seen by the masses is a different ballgame. So the communicator is not the be-all and end-all of the chain. Do you agree to this point? I mean, how do you see this? There's a conflict also.
Okay, fine. You are asking about the communicator role.
Yeah, I mean, I'm saying it's not only up to, say, you want to make people sensitized to a gender and you have a show on it. But how people receive it also, that is also a factor, right? How they look at your communication.
It's everybody's mindset. There are many people who are in favor of Kabir Singh. There are many people who are not in favor of Kabir Singh. Everybody's mindset. We can communicate with you, with a group of these people and a good group of these people. Lekin sabka mindset apna alag alag hai. Koi meri baat se agree karega aur koi meri baat se agree nahi karega. The thing is that, मैंने अपनी बात को बहुत सही तरीके से आपके आगे रख दिया अब आप उस बात को कितना समझेंगे 10% 20% इट्स अप टू यू फाइन अब मैं घर की ही बात करूं अब जैसे अभी इन्होंने बताया प्रीति ने दैट हम कबीर सिंह की बात करें दैट अर्जुन कपूर की मूवी की बात करें इट्स अप टू अस कि हम अपने बच्चों को क्या दिखाना चाहते हैं कौन सी मूवी हम प्रेफर करेंगे और क्या उनका माइंडसेट करेंगे Talking about myself, मैं अपने बारे में ही बात करती हूँ आई एम ब्लेस्ड विथ ट्विंस मेरे दो बेटे हैं एंड दे आर राइट नाउ इन सेकेंड ईयर 19 ईयर्स के हैं दोनों एंड विद मी दे टॉक अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी थिंग उनकी गर्लफ्रेंड को कब पीरियड्स होते हैं दे नो दैट मुझे भी मालूम है कि कब वो मूवी देखने गए और वहाँ उनकी गर्लफ्रेंड को पीरियड्स हुआ और मेरे ही बेटे ने उसको पैड ला के दिया. आई एम फीलिंग वेरी प्राउड सेइंग दिस कि हाँ मेरे बच्चे मुझसे ईच एंड एवरीथिंग रिगार्डिंग कॉन्डम्स एंड ईच एंड एवरीथिंग दे टॉक टू मी. तो आप घर से ही क्यों नहीं शुरुआत करते हैं वुमन एम्पावरमेंट की बात हम लोग यहाँ बैठ के क्यों कर रहे हैं. इट्स अ टाइम टू टीच आर बॉयज कि क्या राइट है क्या रॉन्ग है. इन टॉपिक्स पे खुल के घर से ही शुरुआत होती है. ये पैनल डिस्कशंस या कहीं आप बाहर जाके नुक्कड़ नाटक करेंगे या किसी मूवी को देखना है या उसको ए ग्रेड देना, इट्स नॉट अ थिंग. उससे कुछ नहीं होने वाला.
ब्रिलियंट पॉइंट. आई वांट टू ओपन अप इफ एनीवन हैज क्वेश्चंस सिंस वी हैव अनदर 10 12 मिनट्स.
यू आर द ओनली वन.
दिस इज फॉर हू? आई मीन यू कैन जस्ट
या अ क्वेश्चन. या yet I could not bring myself to see, and I don't watch too many Hindi movies, but I could not bring myself to go and watch Saari Ke Paulsa, something something Kiya Rai, right? The entire entertainment industry, and maybe I'm generalizing here, please forgive me for that, is based on the concept of jo dikhta hai wo dikhta, right? And yet we, exactly as you say, we come to these panel discussions and we talk about, you know, these larger issues. But how is it that we actually intend to, the entertainment industry actually intends to communicate the fact that things need to be a little safer, taking away the takeaway from the previous conversation? How does entertainment make a profit out of speaking about women issues and safety? Because otherwise, same as any other industry, whether the change will come about or not is a...
ओके फाइन. आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू से कि शुरुआत कहाँ से होती है ना. शुरुआत वहीं से होती है जब आप सोचते हैं कि आपको घर से रजाई से निकल के दो कदम तो चलना ही पड़ेगा. आपने हैदर की बात की, आपने बाकी मूवीज़ की बात की, गानों की भी बात की. वही माइंडसेट है. इन्हीं गानों पर डीजे पे लोग डांस भी करते हैं और कुछ लोगों को पसंद भी नहीं आते. तो दो कदम आपको चलना पड़ेगा. फाइल एन आर टी आई, आस्क देम. यू कैन, देयर आर मैनी थिंग्स. सोशल नेटवर्किंग है, फेसबुक है, इंस्टा है, आप इसको अपोज कीजिए. क्यों नहीं करते हैं? आरटीआई डालिए, इस गाने का मतलब क्या होता है, आपने क्यों लिखा, इस अगेंस्ट वो. दो कदम तो उठना पड़ेगा सर जी. आपको यहाँ बैठ के क्वेश्चन पुट अप करने से कुछ नहीं होगा.
सो आई जस्ट, थैंक्स फॉर द क्वेश्चन. आई टेक दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन स्लाइटली अवे फ्रॉम द पॉपुलर मीडिया, फ्रॉम मूवीज, एंड बिकॉज एंटरटेनमेंट इज वाइड. फ्रॉम एडवर्टाइजिंग कोर्स, शेयर द लोड hashtag, right? Such a beautiful narrative to express that, you know, it's the load that everybody needs to share. It's between the couples together to take it up. And so many such nice narratives and campaigns are already existing. And it is a way, it is an initiative to really bring that change, culturally, socially connected again. And therefore, as communicators, our responsibility is to keep up through those narratives. Narratives could be stories like movies, but also about, you know, what is that one thing which can really make our societies look more progressive and slightly more relatable. All those stories which relates to us becomes famous to us and we keep talking about them. I don't know if you remember the names, and to the Me Too movement that Ruhail was talking about happened to be in Japan, called Kutu movement, where women is not allowed to wear heels and they're not allowed to wear spectacles and not allowed to put lipsticks, right? For an environment like this, I think there should be voice against, because it's an equality at the end of the day, and such narratives has the right way. Our job is to bring that narratives to the people, let it see whether it's relate or it fades its own journey.
And Mr. Alka, this is the irony is that that particular song was a massive hit, and what does it tell about the audiences, you know? The culture that we live in is also part of the society, that they also pointed out. The filmmaker has done it, maybe something wrong, but how we accept it and popularize it is also a factor, right?
It's a function of both.
It's a function of both.
Anyone else?
Yeah, please.
I think that used to be a staple part of movies a few years back, that they need to have a song. I mean, what does it tell about the gender sensitization by communicators? What's your question exactly, sir?
Well, it's just a comment. I feel that sometimes,
but it's not rigid.
The way we have normalized this word, yeah.
Absolutely. So I think keeping all the sensor boards in place and keeping all the filters in place, I think everybody is doing their portion of bit in sensitizing what is the right word to be brought to the society. But to the contrary, look at what the generation is. We immediately go to the hacks and we look out for the Netflix story. We don't want to see the censored movie. We want to see what was censored so that we can see what it is, right? So there are two sides of generations to a lot of it. And it's really sad that we are saddled with an imagery of calling women with such titles. I've never seen item boys. Who are they? I don't know if they exist. But therefore, women portrayed into many such castes is really sad. Something that happened at Sabarimala, you know, a woman considered to be the goddess, that's a state country like India say, but on the same side, you know, stopping them at the gateways of the mental. So it's really sad.
Okay, I have a question. What happens when the communicator gets poisoned in a way, not the poison, for example, we see the TV channels, polarized, totally polarized, throwing poison in the society. I mean, do we need a regulation to kind of control it? What is the way, how do we address this when the communicator who has access to the platform misuses it?
That's what I said, now you can file a RTI. This is the simplest way you can do that. आप RTI file कीजिए plus आपके जो TV channel वगैरह आप देखते हैं उसके social networking sites हैं वहाँ जाके आप उनका rating system down कर सकते हैं and they will ask you कि क्या चीज़ आपको कहाँ पे जाकर नहीं अच्छी लग रही. आज के वक्त पे तो आप कोई भी channel देखेंगे आपको पता चल जाएगा whether they are supporting a BJP और आप party और Congress party. किसी भी channel को आप लगाइए within 5 minutes you can get out कि ये किस party को support करते हैं. Better is कि या तो आप उसको switch off कर दीजिए. Switch off is not the मुद्दा. आप एक बिल्ली आ रही है और वो कबूतर को खा रही है और आपने आंखें बंद कर दी, it's not the thing. आपको अपना mindset change करना पड़ेगा और अगर आपको मंजिल तक पहुंचना है तो दो कदम तो आपको उठाने पड़ेंगे. And sorry to say, I'm moving back to the question of that person. Mindset की मैं बात करती हूँ. आपने कहा कि item numbers हैं, bar dancers are too there. मुंबई में हैं. ठीक है, तो चेंज आपको करना पड़ेगा. इस टाइम यहाँ आरजे ना बैठ के एक बार डांसर होती तो शायद आप सोचते कि पता नहीं ये वहाँ कैसे कपड़े पहनती होगी जो आज यहाँ ये कपड़े पहन के बड़ी सती सावित्री बन के बैठी है. तो माइंडसेट आपको खुद चेंज करना पड़ेगा.
क्वेश्चन एज अ मैन, ओनली मैन ऑन द पैनल,
कांग्रेचुलेशंस टू यू.
डू यू थिंक दैट द मेन हैव आल्सो बीन मिसअंडरस्टूड? सपोज यू सेड दैट यू नो दे वुड ऑलवेज परसीव अ वुमन इन अ सर्टेन वे, ओनली मे बी दे रिस्पेक्ट द बार गर्ल हु इज सिटिंग इन द पैनल. Are the men misunderstood also?
Exactly. That's the thing I'm saying, ना कि अपने बच्चों को कम से कम घर से ही समझाना शुरू कीजिए. At least बेटों को. आपकी बेटी 5 बजे घर के बाहर निकलेगी, सबसे पहले आप टाइम देखेंगे, इस टाइम जा रही है, 8 बजे वापस आएगी क्यों? और बेटे को बोलेंगे जा रहा है, अच्छा ठीक है स्कूटी पे जा रहा है, सेफली जाना. फिर उसके बाद आप टाइम देखेंगे और फिर आप बोलेंगे 5 बजे निकल रहा है, अच्छा 8 बजे तक घर आ ही जाएगा ना, आराम से जाना. मेरे बेटे आज भी 7 बजे के बाहर अलाउड नहीं है, वो घर ही बैठे होते हैं. So that कि मेरे एरिया की लड़कियां आराम से घूम सके.
Great. So my final question is this: is there a hope that communicators will be actually, you know, removing whatever the stereotypes are, be able to lessen the stereotypes, the way we perceive women? For example, we talk about male gaze in films and communication. Can that be addressed? Can we have a gender neutral approach to communication somewhere where everybody is respected?
Sure. I think as a communicator and as a individual myself, as a commentator to all these subjects, I really find myself close to women empowerment topics. I take great example of Winfrey Oprah. I take great example of Sheryl Sandberg, you know, who started Lean In Circle. It's a positive psychology. It's a safe environment that we can offer to women, may that be socially, aspirationally, physically, morally. And if, as responsible communicator, I can bring that narrative to the world, I think that's one thing that, you know, we have to take care of. And balancing the communication in the positive side, make sure that it's too sustainable. We have very mature audience here, and I'm sure everybody can differentiate that there is a behavioral change communication process and mass communication. They've been here for a longest period of time. The new wave of communication that's coming today, it's called participatory communication, where you have inroads directly into reaching to the stakeholder. It is participatory in any shape and form. It's just not about putting the writing or putting reading something. It's about expressing your opinion through using those right channels. You asked about poisoning. Companies like Facebook, they're putting policies on hate speech. You know, so if it is an RTI at one place, the community is also absorbing that, yes, we understand there's a hate speech commentary going. So
final
enough
words
and more. Yeah.
Final words. Anything?
Final words. Yeah, sure. Being an RJ, thoda sa aur bardasht karna padega. Kuch toh maine likha jo main lekar aayi hu aaj aap sab ke liye, please. Thank you so much. Taliyan mat marna. Mujhe bahut bura lagega. Okay. Few lines from my side. Sharam nahi aati ab jab rape hota hai. शर्म नहीं आती अब जब रेप होता है, शायद हमने खुद को समझा लिया हो. बच्ची हो या बड़ी, सब एक समान लगती हैं, सब एक चीज या माल लगती हैं इनको. बुरा नहीं लगता अब, शायद हमने खुद को समझा लिया है. कपड़े छोटे मत पहनो, देर रात बाहर मत निकलो, कोई छेड़े तो चुप सह जाओ. तन्हा रास्तों से अकेले मत गुजरो, कतराओ. अब बुरा नहीं लगता इन बातों को सुनना, शायद हमने खुद को समझा लिया है. पर अब जवाब हम भी देंगे, पलट कर हम भी घूरेंगे, देर रात बाहर भी निकलेंगे, कपड़े छोटे भी पहनेंगे, क्योंकि अब हमने खुद को समझा लिया है कि अपनी जंग हमें खुद ही लड़नी है. अपनी जंग हमें खुद ही लड़नी है, किसी के रोके से रुकना नहीं है. नज़र सामने वाले की बुरी है तो पर्दा हमें करना नहीं है. नज़र सामने वाले की बुरी है तो पर्दा हमें करना नहीं है. हम भी सांस लेते हैं, ये समझाना है सबको. हम कोई माल नहीं, ये अब बताना है सबको. डरना नहीं है अब, डराना है उसको जो देखे बुरी नजर से, अब समझाना है उसको. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू सो मच.